Hiya, kittens! We are back with part two, and you see the spooky shadow over there? I think we're back with part two. We better be back with part two of the cursed forest. Hi, crows! Ooh, spooky, spooky. Okay. So, recap. We are trying to figure out what's going on in this town while simultaneously getting to a place where we can get to the hospital to see our mother. Oh, I'm just going higher and higher. I want to go left. Ooh, all right. Squirrels. Seriously, what are you? Do I want to dive? Ooh, what's that glowy thing? Oh, this is like a nice little place to sit and just like chill. Look how pretty it is. And if like the moon's out, you could see the moon. Let's get over here where the person dove. Was that a good thing or a bad thing? I don't know. Like, I don't wanna. Oh, hi. We're going underwater. Alright, we're back. There's this blue glowing altar? I don't know. This is all uncharted territory now. All uncharted territory. What are you? Ooh, yes, you are an altar. And we're gonna overwrite our original saves. First off, I gotta see. Okay, so we are definitely. So we're gonna build the whole skeleton? That's cool. What are you? Oh, more maps. I am here. There's a road this way. Drowning fishy body thing. I think that's where I just came from. More of the settlement. An apple, which is what the loading screen was. The loading screens are phenomenally gorgeous. Like, phenomenally gorgeous. Evil creature. Bucket. Ooh, a big windy road to mountains or more settlements. And there's a fountain, or is that for the altar? Let's. Oh my Jesus, you crows. So this is do not go here? Oh my God, it's getting really misty. I don't know what that sound is. I am pretty spooked, and I just heard bubbling. If I die, I'm not that far in. Hi. Oh, it's gonna kill me, isn't it? Like, I'm in a marsh. Okay. Run straight to it! Look, oh. Fogs! Okay, the music's gotten so epic in this area. Maybe going to the place that shows death was not a good idea. Oh my God, that's almost too loud for me on the music. Oh, it does kill me. So we're gonna be starting back. Hi. Oh, hi. Am I? Oh, what? I was supposed to say, am I upside down? Am I hanging? Oh, I can't control. I can't control what's going on. Oh jeez. Was I Oh. Hi frogs. So this was not a place for me to go. Oh, it was. Give me. I want this. I don't care if I die more. We have to collect all the body parts. And before I die again, we're gonna save. Alright. There's the evil scarecrow. So I believe that I'm picking up bones to do that sacrifice, but I have no idea how to get out of here now. I would love to say, like, I wish there was a whole map thing, but we don't. I don't care about that. Alright, Scarecrow. I have lived here all my life, playing in the fields under the watchful eye of the Scarecrows. My neighbor, an old man whose name I do not recall, used to spend a lot of time in his garden. He was a settler with a violent skin condition that meant most of his life was spent alone and away from the comfort of others. As he sold his small plot of land, he spoke in hushed tones to his scarecrow, and I began to notice that other villagers purposely looked away when he did this. One day, passing the old man conversing with the straw one, I grew suddenly bold. "Do you believe the scarecrow will speak back?" I asked. "It is not wise to say such things, little girl. A scarecrow cannot talk," he smiled darkly. "However, the same cannot be said of what is living inside. It grows stronger every day, and as it waits, it watches. Nothing can stop it. I suggest that you don't try to stand in its way." His face grew suddenly ashen, and he began to speak again to the scarecrow. "No, I didn't. She's harmless. She won't tell anyone, will you?" He grew more and more frantic of his hands, reaching out to grab me, to beg me to keep a secret that I didn't understand. I ran. The next day, the old man was found dead. His garden quickly started to rot as though the land had been poisoned. Soon after, I contracted a dreadful fever, and as I lay awake, tossing and turning, I looked out my window and saw the scarecrow pressed up against the glass. I hid under the covers and eventually fell into a restless sleep. When I woke up, he was gone. But from that point on, I have always felt his eyes watching me from the field. He helps me follow everyone. Mr. Straw Hat is a very good friend. Is there any secrets? Like, okay, I was supposed to say, will I die if I go down there? Like, this is a big marsh bog. Hi, friend. Oh, did I just die? Oh no, this is different. Oh sweet, I did die. Epic. I'm lost in like the first, what, 10 minutes of me playing. That's great, zombie. Oh. Bubble, bubble. Toil and trouble. Something's in the water and it wants to kill me. So now I have to hop from place to place, but I don't know. Oh, I see flashing lights over there. Okay. Okay. I did not figure it out. I'm going the wrong way. Okay. So this place flooded while I was being hung upside down next to Mr. Scarecrow Man. Nope, that's not the way, because we're going to die in the bog. I don't know if this is called a bog or if it's just like a marshland. Oh, okay. I think I found the way out. I believe I found the way out. Thank you, flashy lights. Ooh, street lights. Thank you for helping me. Is this the map? Yes. Well, not the map, but it's the... Oh. Two ways. That way or that way. We are going to go... Oh, hi, dear. I almost wish I was looking that way when you first... That's spooky. Okay. I'm also doing this without eating for like an entire day. So we'll see how good that serves me with my anxiety. I do not recommend if you have anxiety or depression to not eat. Ooh, automatic save. Spook spooks. Spook spooks are on their way. Ooh, a note. About Yan. Our leader asked me not to touch him. He said that making him disappear would evoke unwanted attention. But all Yan has brought to our settlement so far is trouble. I remember when he first came to us. He used to make trips into the city, which wasn't normal to any of us. Our settlers don't need people like him, but out of kindness, we gave him a chance. I tried to invite him to my house for supper cooked by my wife. I thought that would be meeting him eye to eye. We would get to know him better. And with an acquaintance, he would become better accustomed to our lifestyle. He refused my invitation. Then I invited him hunting. Even this he criticized, telling stupid stories about his past and how he had decided never to take the life of an animal for sport. My dislike for him grows by day. I wasn't fooled for a moment by his innocent facade. Yang came to us pretending to be a saint, but everyone has their sins. Soon he will learn that the past never truly stays in the past. When we were together, his attempts to turn the conversation towards our leader, trying to steal information out of me about his family, it unnerves me. He may be untouchable for the moment, but that will be quickly changing once we completed the ritual. Then the sinners will get what they deserve. So what is this ritual? I assume it's a sacrifice. Like most horror-ish games are like sacrifice. So Explorer, Yan, and Sarah. Oh, so Sarah's is the scarecrow note? Okay. That just looks like someone's there. Right, what is this? Any secrets? Like, I didn't get all the notes last time, and I definitely want all the notes. And I can't go upstairs, can I? Want to go in here. Creepy shadow people. Oh. Hi. Okay. I don't even know what I got. It said, oh, one of these runestone ritual elements. I found one. Okay. So I guess I need to collect. Oh my God, my shadow scared me. Okay. What is this? Okay. Oh, a book. What's the book? I can't read the book. Wonder if that's a real language. I cannot believe my luck. I found the runestone. It is the very last element we needed for the ritual. And as a reward, our glorious leader thanked me personally and made me its keeper. In his wisdom and kindness, he also gives me a small house near the lake, which is much, much more pleasant than my previous home. Soon we will wash this land of sin, while the weak-willed seek redemption in the death and the promise of different perfect world. We are fighting to make our earthly realm that haven. With our help, the people here will become perfect specimens of humanity, unspoiled entities, cleansed of depravity. The sea takes a shard of jagged glass and washes it smooth. So too shall we shape this world into one of our own creation, and I will be among the chosen, forging the way. Change is coming, and I shall be one of the leading architects of the future. I think I read that with a little bit more gusto, but I think that's like the emotion and conveying that was behind it. Is that me? I'm scared. That's me. Okay, can I leave through this door? It's locked. Great! Spooky spooks? Okay, no spooky. Hi? No? Oh, I did not even see that guy there. Hi, don't kill me. I can do the ritual for you. No. I have a key. Free. I'm 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 free. Oh my God, you, this game is so terrifying. Like I get like it's not supposed to be that spook of a game. But I definitely want to make sure I cover all the grounds 'cause I don't want to miss a thing. So that is this way and up. Oh, that was a little glitchy. Oh, look. Bridge that's gonna fall apart. Almost didn't make it. Oh. So the shadowy things are like prevalent here. All right. Well, let's. Can I not go forward? Why? I want to go. We'll try this again. Jump, jump, jump. I want to go. I don't know why I can't go that way. I'm not in the right mind right now, apparently. Oh, a shed that actually lets me in and open? No, please. I'm gonna get locked in here. It's an outhouse. This floor is gonna fall apart under me. Oh my God, I didn't even get a chance to read that. Hi. Leave me alone for crying out loud. Oh my God, I don't know if I'm doing bad. I don't know if this is how it's supposed to progress. That thing's trying to kill me. I don't know if that's the soul of the glorious leader or a soul of someone who needs to be saved, but oh my God. Help. Okay, yay. This is the exact note. I'm like, I wanted to read the note. I want to know the lore. I tried hard, but I can't easily escape this place. No, shiitake, Sherlock. Yeah, I can't leave this place either, and it doesn't want me to leave. That's why for now I've given up attempting to leave. Instead, I'll continue to research and solve the mysteries of what happened here. Oh God, I can't escape till probably like section 5. The shadow of the past covers this land like a suffocating lead blanket, woven of pain and suffering. Time here moves cryptically in circles, the past and present merging to show unspeakable horrors. Hidden amongst the trees, you can hear the voices of the past calling to you. I think I'm connected, or perhaps tethered to this place. It won't let me leave. I even can't tell how much time has passed. There's no way to distinguish 1 hour from another. The forest is sucking the life from me. I need to find a way out of here, or this place is going to kill me. The madness around me has blended reality and nightmare into one hellish existence. I need to hold on to myself and write down any useful information so I don't miss a thing. I hope that what I find will help the next person trapped here, and he will inform the world of my efforts. I don't want to die nameless. Do I get to learn the name of the explorer? Because I think that's the explorer's note, right? Yeah. Let's leave. Spooky Spook's gonna pop out again, isn't he? Oh, it's not a fork in the cave. Okay, I was just about to cry because it's a fork in the cave. Nope. Oh my God, this is so creepy. But what? Oh my God. Hi, jump scares. I was just gonna suggest that what if I'm the person that's sneaking around? Like, what if this is me seeing the future of myself, which is probably not true? And then this happened. Ha. Right, we are free. Boop. Cool. Ooh, we're back at the shed. All right, and I got stuck. Hoo hoo hoo. I don't know if that's novel or not, but we are going here. We are going here. Ooh. Ooh. Is this like actual land? So I don't. Oh, that's. Ooh. That's that area. Okay, well then we'll just go back to the dock. I took the long way to get to the dock. All right, let's swim and hope that nothing kills me in the water. This log just came out of nowhere. Awesome. Alter. Save. Okay, I don't know where I'm going. Am I supposed to go back in that house? Like, I just noticed, like, the darkness there. Whatever. We'll just swim. We'll swim for a bit. Swimming's never done anything to anyone. Which reminds me, I should go swimming this summer. I haven't gone swimming in, like, ages. Boop, 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 boop. Nope. I'm swimming through plants. Oh, hey. There is a path here that I didn't see. Awesome. Go across. Is across another path, or is it just like me being stupid? Me being stupid. Okay. I just don't want to miss a thing. I really, really don't. Okay. Hi. Thank you. That's gonna kill me. Ha. Look. Oh, that's black smoke. I guess we leave the black smoke. You tried to kill me, but you can't. I'm going to escape this place, and you're not going to stop me. Fish? I'm hoping these bubbles are fish. Oh, hi. Oh my God, where am I going? What am I doing? I'm following you back to land. Sweet. Oh, and it saved. Awesome. Oh my God. Would my phone stop vibrating? That's freaking me out even more. Okay, I know I can't go further because of those. I just want to see if anything's there. I can always cut out me being weird and like running off the off-beaten path just to make this more cohesive. Look, there's a fireplace. Ooh, and another altar. And the deer's back! My friend, the deer. Oh. And the scarecrow. I can't do anything with the scarecrow. But I'm so far from where that map was. Let's go get the altar. Are you? Are you a note? You are a note. I want to save before I read the note. I have three more to go of those. Ooh. One more bone piece. Oh, wow. Oh, it's a two-page. Ooh, it's a tourist note. 21st of October. I spent all month cramped in my small room with a soldering iron, working on my radio receiver. The last student project doesn't have to be submitted until April, so I'm way ahead, which is why I agreed to go camping with some friends. We're all from the city, so taking a vacation outdoors would be an unforgettable trip, hopefully for all the right reasons. Yurai says that he has found an interesting place to set up camp, so everything is ready, and I better start packing for my meeting with nature. The 25th of October. It's the first day of the trip, and we've already failed. We couldn't buy any booze in the shop. The seller said that we were too young. We had no choice but to awkwardly buy a bunch of lemonade. Luckily, Simon brought a huge flask with him. That should make the lemonade more interesting. October 26th, we made a camp and set up a campfire, but before that went to wet our feet in the river. After so many hours in the small car, it was great to be out in nature. This place has a lot of creepy urban legends, lots of them about people disappearing. Nikolai told us some scary stories about black houses with black coffins. It might just be because of too much lemonade, but I'm starting to feel strangely uncomfortable in this place. Still, it's just my imagination. Nothing can happen to me yet. I still have exams to pass. October 27th. Ludmila, Rustim, and Zenaida. Sorry if I've butchered any names here, because some of them I'm just like, I don't recognize them. Drank way too much. It covered a beautiful looking stone monument in empty lemonade bottles. I think the students from our archaeological club would die for a chance to see this thing. It looks like a really ancient altar. The forest itself is incredibly dense. I almost broke my neck tripping over some roots. I swear the trees are doing it on purpose. In the evening, we found a weird ladder leading somewhere, but we're all so exhausted that we decided to explore it later. Ooh, forewarning or forewarning, foreboding. We get a ladder to explore. How long are these? Okay, not that much longer. October 29th. 29th. October 28th. I thought this trip would be perfect time to tell Ludmilla about my feelings for her. But of course, Rustum hasn't let me get a moment alone with her. It's so typical of him. He seems to get any girl he wants, and the moment any of us show interest, he claims them for himself. I didn't want him on this trip with us. He always ruins everything. He's good friends with Yurai, though. So I couldn't tell anyone about how I feel. October 29th. Georgie came back from his walk in the forest, absolutely frantic and panicking. He said that he had seen a ferocious-looking creature between the trees with lowering eyes. Ooh, you either saw the rabbit or the deer! How much fun! Rustum tried to laugh it off. He told Georgie that he must have drunk too much. Rustum, being the huge show-off that he is, has gone into forest to look for him. The girls tried to stop him, but he had his mind set on being a hero. I can't believe this is happening. It all happened so fast. Rustum came back. He was covered in blood. He was crawling toward us, screaming at us to run. Everybody ran as fast as they could from our camp, but it was so stupid. The nearest city is 100 kilometers from here. We all got separated now, and I'm alone and lost, and this is an awful place. I'm leaving these notes dotted around like breadcrumbs, hoping that the rescue group will find them. Please don't give up searching for us. I'm trying to stay hopeful, but I don't know if I can survive this nightmare. Why did we come here? What's gonna kill me now? It is eerily. It is airy, erringly, erringly quiet. I don't know if that's a word. I really don't. But it's too quiet. This is. I can't run! I'm gonna die by a boulder! Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god! I'm gonna hide. Oh, can I just. That's what we're doing. We're jumping to the side. Boop. Where is it coming? That rock just fell. Oh, is it not coming? Can I hide here? Oh, I clipped through the wall. Nope. There has to be like a safe haven. Stay. I survived. Yes. Yes. Ha. You didn't kill me yet. You won't kill me. No one can kill the zombie kitty. I'm already dead. I'm a living, breathing. I'm an undead kitty. Hello. What is that? That looks cool. So, power? Power. This is another beautiful like place to just kind of like sit and think. There's a place like that by my house. It's not like a cliff like this, but like it's high up enough where you could sit on the edge and just like watch the people play in the pond that you're not supposed to play in. Ooh. Altar. Sweet. Bridge didn't break. I didn't die. Oh, that looks like what it's depicted over there. Is there an altar here? Why? It's so quiet. I am that terrified. Oh, spooky shadows. Ooh, just what I wanted. A note. Rune. I found an old rune which offers some clues as to the events which transpired here. The territory around it is littered with dangerous traps, and now I know why. It appears to be a place of sacrifice, despite all my years of experience. I have to wonder how this kind of ancient place has remained unknown to us for so long. Whilst exploring the region, I haven't found any indications that the sacrificial ritual was connected with any particular religion or satanic following, which makes the purpose of the sacrifice itself more obscure and enigmatic. My experience in investigating cults and zealous frantics has consistently found a pattern of erratic disorganization. Followers living poorly and the hierarchy fragile, in contrast, this one seems to have been somewhat stable, which I believe is why they were able to remain self-sufficient and secluded. Plan's framework suggests that the followers were not recruited and indoctrined from birth, with perhaps no experience or even knowledge of the outside world, creating strong bonds and family ties between members. Despite this place's sinister feel, the mystery of these people carries me along and deep within me. I wonder if I might uncover something more than just the history of events that have taken place here. When I finish this investigation, my legacy will be forever remembered in a history as a researcher who uncovered the secrets from such an arcane place. Sweet! I would love an altar to save, but I don't think I'm getting that. So I gotta go to that purple thing. Alright, so I don't know like what these campfires are for. All right. Let's do this. Hi. I don't want to go there. But I guess I have to. Oh, more bones. Give me the bones. I want your bones. How do I get the bones? You're purple and glowing. I don't know what this is doing, but am I allowed to have bones? Yeah. And it's completed. Can I get another one of these? No, but it's saved. Okay. I don't know where to go after this. Oh. Okay, well. Hi. Ha! Funny crows, trying to scare me. I'm a zombie kitty, and I can eat you. Okay. All right. So we're back. That doesn't look like a way to go. Okay, we're back. Food? I don't think think I should eat the food. Yes, let's definitely eat the food. Wait, is that a note? The apples are poisoned. Hi. All right. Nope, we're dying. Oh no, that's actually progress. Awesome. I love that. Oh, hi, do not smash my how. My head, it hurts. You smashed my head. So we're not touching. If I remove this, can I get the bucket? No. Okay. Bye. So, I couldn't go this way. Can I go this way now? Because I feel like I just did this. Ha, that's why the apples are here. Clues, foreboding. Why don't I pay attention? Is this where I just came from? Yeah, this is where I just came from. Boop. No, this isn't where I came from, but this is where the thing I couldn't go to last time, I think. If I couldn't before, I can now. That's the teddy bear. As we all know, no picking things up. I am missing a Sarah, an explorer, and a people. Who are you? Toys. I'm so lonely up here. Sometimes I find a toy to play with, and for a while my boredom is subdued. Together we play games to test their worth. They lie, cheat, betray, and do anything to satisfy their own desires. They think of nothing but greed and cowardice. Okay, the screen is shaking. That was confusing me. And it makes them so much fun to play with. But my toys are fragile, and my games always seem to break them. Then I'm alone again. One day, a stronger toy will come, and then the real fun should start. Am I a stronger toy? As a sentence I never thought was possible. Yeah, this. What? I don't even want to know. Hi. I don't want to pick you up. Oh, you are what I need. Okay. You're not something that's going to kill me. Oh, look, another outlook. How pretty. All right. That. Why? Why is that happening? I want to make it to the altar. Just let me get to the altar. Save. You can kill me after I save. All right. So now we continue this way. Oh, it is the deer. That was a trap and I just died. Or maybe not. We don't know. 'Cause sometimes it feels like you die and sometimes it's just like, hey, progression of the story. Oh, possibly progression of the story 'cause whoever that is does not want me to leave and wants me to die in here all alone. To leave this off here and we are going to continue this the entirety of the way. This game is gorgeous, it's beautiful, it's spooky, like super spooky, super creepy. Always, I will leave the link for it down below. If you liked this video, please like, comment, and subscribe in that order, or not in that order, whatever you do, your choice. Thank you and have a good night.